Welcome back to What Arty Noobs with General Disturbance. This is an IKV 90 Type B. It's a Swedish Tier 7 tank destroyer. Battle has already started. We're on the south spawn of Muravanka. And I think somebody's having a bit of trouble here. Okay, he's moving away from his firing position. Moving away to a firing position. It's Ratty 87. And he's in the Swedish tank destroyer, the IKV 90 Type B. 90mm gun, or 9cm, depending on which way you look at it. Designed by the Bofors company as a light tank, not a tank destroyer. At least that's what they were searching for initially. But they came up with this tank destroyer, and it was a project that continued from 1965 to 1966. And it was designed, but no prototype was ever built, and it was discontinued. Okay, we've got an SU-1000 in view. Oh, lovely round into him. 246 in. And he got some damage assistance because he was hit the moment he was tracked. Oh, he gets the kill. 160. Now, his gun will penetrate 210 hit point millimeter. Took a hit there from the MX-12 tank and in the gun. Oh, needs to get below the ridgeline quickly. That MX-12 tank obviously was nearby. There's the T-43. They'll do 240 alpha damage with the gun and 210 millimeters of penetration. Trying to get a shot on the T-43. Oh, fires around a bit too late. He was moving. Okay, he's been badly damaged. He's lost nearly half his hit points. He's pulled up. There's heavy tank number 6. That's the Japanese version of the Tiger. T-43, we could just about make out around the corner. Put a round into him. 259. That's a high roll. And the heavy tank number 6 was hit, but he's still coming on. We put a round into him. And get hit in return by the heavy tank. 212, we can get another reload in, and yes, finish him off. Second kill. Still got to deal with these enemies. In fact, now we're desperately trying to defend this corner because the KV-3's come around the corner. Most of the team went up through the Magic Forest, and we're the only ones who actually went to the west. We've got a T-21 behind us defending us, but and the RT's down in the south of the map. But oh, we're getting around into the Nashorn. 242. It's a high roll, but only just. And that horn goes down. That's good. T-43 still there. So is the KV-3. So basically, we're spotting for the team every time we pop up. And we've got the T-21 further back behind us. Yep. 224. That's a low roll. There's that AMX-12 ton, the one that hit us at the start of the battle. It's got a four-shot autoloader. And the KV-3 is behind that ridgeline. Go for the AMX 12 ton. Yes! Yes, that's better. 251 high roll. Gets one back for the damage he caused us. And the AMX 12 ton is backing off. T-43 is still behind the building. But he's just exposed himself a little. We're dialed in. I'm not sure if we actually got a tracking shot there. Oh, we can get him now. Yes! And we wipe him out. That's our third kill. Right, AMX 12 ton. Can we get a shot on him? He's behind the building. Difficult shot. No, we can't get a shot on him. He's in cover. The KV-3, though, is behind the ridgeline. And our teammates are now flooding in from the east side of the map to distract the enemy. And they're going for the kill, so we might as well go up and attack that KV-3 head-on. Going for the shot on his engine bay. Oh, get around him. 241, we can keep moving. We can turn around him so he can't traverse his turret quickly enough. Oh, he's got it down. Ouch. Yeah, but the KV-3 went down immediately afterwards. He was taken out by our SU-8. And there's only two enemy remaining, both RT, the S-51 and the Hummel. So we certainly did well in the battle. But unfortunately, we did die. So that takes away the opportunity to platoon with somebody and pick up a Brubston Arms. And both party have now been killed, and the game is over. So it's victory. So let's have a look at the end of battle stats. It's an ace tank of Arati 87 in the IKV 90B. He's finally got his ace tanker. He also picked up a spotter because he was spotting for the team. He was the furthest forward, actually, on the west side of the map. So he was spotting for all the damage being done against those tanks on the west side. He also picked up a fire for effect for doing more damage than the hit points of his own vehicle, but he didn't pick up any other awards. He did the highest amount of damage overall. In fact, he didn't pick up the high caliber. So, a bit surprising there. 2,067 hit points of damage. He also got the highest number of kills alongside the Wizzy 131. Both managed to pick up three. If only he'd actually stayed alive, he would have been able to platoon with the Wizzy 131 and pick up a Brothers in Arms. When it came to base XP, he was the highest with 1,076. The Wizzy 131 managed to get 995. Then came the SU-8 with 597. So, if we look at detail report... Well, we can see he fired 13 rounds during the battle. He got 11 direct hits, 10 penetration, damage of 2,067 hit points, of which 406 were at more than 300 meters. He received 5 hits during the battle. 4 were penetration, 1 was non-penetration. This is a testament to the fact that it's a very lightly armored vehicle, and you don't really want to be seen by the enemy if you can help it, because if they do see you, they're more than likely going to get their shots into you. He received also 1 hit as a result of splash damage as well. He spotted 4 enemy vehicles. He damaged 6 of the enemy, killed 3 of them, and he managed to get damage assistance of 1,603 hit points. That's because he managed to track the SU-101 and other tanks and then allow teammates to hit them. On a premium account, he earned 43,949 credits, and after repair and ammunition resupply, he took away 33,309 credits. He received 1,614 XP times 2 for the first victory, took away 3,228 experience points altogether. But it only took him 25 games to get the ace tanker on this tank. So that's pretty good at going, actually, if you think about it, to get the ace tanker that quickly. I think it did help that he was the furthest tank forward on the west side. So really, basically, he was gaining a lot of spotting damage from spotting the enemy tanks and allowing his teammates behind them to put shells into them. And that really did help his bump his score up to get the ace tanker. So if you enjoyed this replay, please give it a like and do subscribe to our channel. And hopefully it'll be your replay that I'll be featuring in the next video.